Northwest Wales, Anglesey. The home of standing stones and ancient burial chambers is Holy Island. But there's an ungodly mess. 60 tons of Goliath cranes dangling 20 metres in the air on the site of the old Anglesey aluminium plant. Tony Jackson needs a solution.
Willie, if you can push that middle bit away again, that worked well then. It really moved. The centrepiece has just moved. That's it, Willie. Paul, can you not hit this side bit?
High reach driver Saul Nyland is worried about the small excavators in the pit.
Listen, if Paul goes in there now and grabs hold of that with his bucket, it's going one way, mate, and it's right on top of his digger. That won't just come and land like that. It'll come on its end and twist again.
But the only option is to get up close.
Right, you smash it. Right, Willie, just stay where you are, mate, for the minute. Lee's going to try and smash it down on his side. Lee, cut the top. That's it. Kirsty, it wasn't exactly a textbook, but he's half down. Here we go.
Only the front section has come down. The back piece is still stuck in the air.
It's not exactly how we planned it, obviously. But the front beam's come away, so it's broken itself up a little bit. They're heavier than we thought. I think it's safe to say that.
There's only one tactic for this job.
Right, Lee, ready for a push?
Yeah, let's do it, boys. Swat it! Yeah, that's it. What a poxy beat. Willie Sad, can you give it another nudge? Yeah. In the pull. Yeah. Tim Martin. Job's a good one. After much buggeration, I think we caught in the trade. First one's down, and I think we're going to have a cup of tea.
Well, great time. Thank you.
The crew can have a quick tea break. Even the machines are allowed to cool down. But the clock is always ticking. This site won't clear itself. One down, one to go. As the crash mat's cleared, Tony has time to think and adapt.
We've learned from our mistakes. It is a bit heavier than we thought. There's not much room for error. You're talking inches, so it only takes one side to be going a little bit faster than the other, and you've got a wedge piece of steel that weighs possibly 50, 60 tons.
The rear crane is slowly pushed towards the edge of the cliff.
Go on. Lovely, mate, lovely. That's not what we want. Take, come off it.
But the crane keeps getting stuck.
We messed about with the building. It's broken some of the nuts away, and the track's not quite running true, in which case we're going to struggle. Give it another push, mate. Get a bond on.
It's time for the Scrap King's lasso.
Okay, Lee, right, if you want to take the strain on that bond there, mate. Christy, you're ready on the other side. Paul, you're ready, yep. Okay, we're a little bit close here. Let's get back a bit. Pull it and see what happens. Steady, Wolf. Okay, gents. Christy, give it a nudge.
And just when they thought it would never budge.
Yeah, here we go. Go on. Keep going. Oh, right?
Just the final back beam, in need of a nudge.
Right, okay, yeah, go, yes, okay. There you are.
To become a king of scrap, sometimes you need to go off script.
That's all she wrote. Sometimes you win, sometimes you lose, but no one's hurt, and the plant's down, we'll chop it up, get some sizable bits, and move on to the rest of the shed.
Another part of the UK's industrial heritage is recycled. The scrappers have plenty of work to do, but they've made way for an eco-park that'll make new resources for sustainable energy and food for future generations.